Hi guys, welcome back. If you're new, my name is Tanel and today we dive deep into zinc, the master mineral, as I often refer to it. In the general context, you will often see magnesium being called this and carrying this title of being the master mineral, and there is truth to that. A lot of people would sleep better, relax more, and get all those different benefits, so magnesium is nice, but when it comes to specifically healing the skin, the gut, supporting the liver, and all those different roles that zinc plays, zinc is very noteworthy. So every time someone successfully has skin progress, they send me their before and after photos and messages of gratitude for the course and ebook, I have made it a habit to always ask them, now retrospectively, looking back at the journey, reading your daily diary, what would you say in conclusion, what would you list as your top 10 helpers? So anything that supported you along the journey, anything that helped you, anything that became a staple in your diet or something you fixed that you really saw results from, and your top 10 enemies. So anything that held you back, triggers, troublemakers. And very often, you know, you would see the same patterns going on. And even though zinc does get mentioned a lot, the first two examples that I remember are these two. But besides those, I am also an example of that. So when I was healing my skin years ago, I came from the background of recovering from veganism. I was an ex-vegan. So this is a very typical situation when you're coming from a malnourished state. You will be overloaded with copper and not have enough zinc. This is typical for vegans. And in my case, it was the same. Zinc really helped me get through it and I would see those benefits in action. Zinc is awesome. So let's cover the benefits of zinc. What are the roles in the body that it plays? What are the signs of deficiency that you should be looking out for? What kind of supplementation options there are? Is it worth supplementing the normal stuff or how should we look at it? And of course, the most high quality, most praised foods to get your natural, bioavailable, effective zinc from. And we will start from the skin stuff. Zinc directly helps your body to produce better skin cells, faster wound healing, better tissues, stronger tissues. It also helps to produce collagen naturally in the body. So about collagen, we'll talk about collagen in a different video. But generally speaking, you can eat collagen, you can synthesize it. And zinc is one of those minerals, one of those nutrients that help that process for your body to create more collagen, which is the main structural protein of the skin. That's what the skin is made of. And needless to say, this is exactly what we're looking for. We want better skin, faster healing, and also better hydration. So once your body is able to create better cells, it also holds on to hydration better. This ties together into other minerals, potassium we've already mentioned, but zinc also helps with stronger cell walls. As a nutrient, zinc is also a great antioxidant. So it helps against oxidative damage. We want that. But usually people think of antioxidants as something you get from green tea or superfood berries. But what they don't realize or don't think of or haven't really been taught is that many animal foods also give you antioxidants. For example, cholesterol is a great antioxidant and zinc as a mineral is also. You want to keep inflammation down and you want to control the oxidation. Zinc helps with both of those. Now, zinc also helps with gut health. And with gut health specifically, zinc helps to strengthen your stomach acid. And there are many ways to do that. We go into it in the course, of course, but zinc helps you to build better stomach acid, and a better, stronger stomach acid helps you absorb nutrients better and keep away any pathogens or anything that shouldn't go down further into your digestive tract. It helps to neutralize that, and it also helps to absorb other nutrients. So zinc plays a direct role in fixing gut health. Now, the next step is, of course, immunity. But immunity is something that people usually oversimplify. They think that immunity is your ability to not catch a cold. Sure, that is part of it, fevers and such. But immunity is also how you regulate yourself, your organism, in relation to the rest of the world. The skin as an organ, I would say, is immunity that you have externally. So most of the immune system is somewhere inside, in your gut. But the skin itself is also part of this whole immune system. And zinc directly helps you stay healthy, stay strong, immune, both internally and externally. Pretty much the main trifecta of root causes within the body while you're healing your skin, stuff that you want to regulate and fix and support, is gut health, immunity, and liver health. There are others as well, but these three are like the huge roots of the whole problem. And so zinc also helps not only gut health and immunity, but also it supports the liver. It's one of those essential nutrients that directly play a role in supporting liver function and detoxification. So liver, of course, it filters out and detoxes and cleans your blood, and it shouldn't be overburdened. We get deep into this stuff in the course, but zinc plays a huge role in all of that. Further on, zinc also helps with hormonal health. So you probably have heard that zinc directly helps men have natural testosterone, and that is not just a way to imitate some sort of a cartoon character of a man. Testosterone is needed while you're healing your skin as a man, because this is what gives you control, patience, it's what keeps you grounded, and also makes you lead yourself out of that horrible situation that you have with your skin towards a goal. And another side of hormonal health, of course, is hormonal acne, for example, that a lot of women struggle with. So zinc is one of those nutrients that for women helps to clear up the skin as well through fixing and regulating and boosting hormonal health. And what is very closely related to hormonal health is fertility. Now, maybe you are not planning to become a father or a mother or start a family, but fertility still is a very strong natural biomarker of good health. If you are infertile, that is a sign that something is wrong. You are not healthy. So becoming fertile, hormonally healthy, that is one way that you can bring more balance, more robust health into your life, and also by extension heal your skin. And some other less known zinc benefits have to do with protection from the UV rays. You can also use zinc oxide in a sunscreen, for example. There is some research done into zinc helping protect you against EMF damage, electromagnetic frequencies. Zinc can help you with brain health, with thyroid health. So as you can see, zinc is extremely versatile, and it directly supports all those different pillars of health, which is the way to heal your skin. Now let's look at some signs of deficiency. What is something you should be looking out for? Maybe you should boost those levels of zinc. First of all, you get skin issues. Eczema, psoriasis, acne, different types of dermatitis, but also dandruff. So people don't realize that dandruff is not something that has to do with the hair exactly. It is in the hair, but it comes from the scalp, which is, of course, the skin. You can also notice how zinc deficiency can lead to hair loss or alopecia. Now, hairs, of course, come from the follicle, and that is in the skin, so very often the things that create problems in the skin lead to problems with hair. And speaking of hair, hormonal problems can bring facial hair on women, and it can lead men down paths of low testosterone. Now, low testosterone is not just something to make fun of. Low testosterone means that you have self-sabotaging thoughts. You're holding yourself back. You feel weak. You don't have control. You are always confused. You keep spinning your wheels. So hormonal health is very important in the way that you view the world, view yourself, get things done, and actually live the life that you want to live. Since zinc directly plays a role in creating better cells, faster wound healing, it has to do with growth and development. So when you are young, or you can see children having inadequate growth problems, developmental issues, and slow wound healing, things like that, that can stem from low zinc levels, zinc deficiency. Of course, that can be accompanied with low energy, low libido, depression. You might be more sensitive, more susceptible to allergic reactions. You might have bad sleep and so on. You might develop more itch. Of course, we will talk about itch in a different video some other time, really diving into itch. But as you can see, zinc is really important. And some ways that you can become deficient is when you don't eat enough good quality foods. But some interesting things that I found when I was diving deeper into this research is, I'm going to show you this on the screen, but what I remember from this one research, they were comparing these two ways that zinc could be eaten and utilized more effectively in the body. The first experiment was to just slunk down raw oysters, very good way to get zinc. And the other was combining it with other foods, bread, and other foods that had phytic acid. And phytic acid is one of those anti-nutrients that can bind to certain nutrients or minerals and prevent your body from effectively using it, absorbing it. On all of my videos, when you go into the description box, you can see that I have listed the articles and studies mentioned. Anytime you get curious, just check it out. The same applies here. Oysters themselves, that's an awesome way to get zinc. That's pretty much the number one option. I have heard of black ants, a supplement, ground up black ants being a good source of zinc, but that's not something very common. Oysters is the number one food to eat to get more zinc. That can be just popping up a raw oyster with an oyster knife and slunking it down. Now you can use some lemon juice on that to pre-digest it a little bit, but I wouldn't really mix it with something else like an oyster pasta, for example, unless you know that you do well with grains and wheat and stuff like that. In my view, when you are healing, you're looking for supplements and best foods to do that. And oysters you might not eat all the time. You might have never had an oyster, but this is a good opportunity to try new things and keep that regular. You don't have to eat them daily, but maybe once a week, maybe a couple of times a month, you would have an oyster day. It's a great way to increase zinc levels. And besides oysters, you have other seafood, you have crab, you have shrimp, and you can also eat the shrimp with the cover on, so the skin or the shell on. That's a good way to get calcium, for example. But if you don't have access to fresh oysters, or you just don't see yourself getting into that, one way to get oysters for you is to use the supplemental kind of oysters, which is just dried up oysters. That's a great way to get zinc and some other nutrients as well. I have tried it out many times. I liked it. It's good stuff. The link is down in the description below. Use the coupon code to get a discount. Besides seafood, don't worry. You also get zinc from high quality beef, lamb, goat, other meats, also organ meats like liver. You can also get good zinc from raw dairy, kefir. And there's also some research about cacao. So like high quality chocolate might be. There's also a good way to get copper. So some of these foods, you can look at liver, for example, it has both copper and zinc. And besides that, you also have poultry. So you have turkey, you have chicken, you have eggs and things like that. But if you're looking for a supplement, so the usual zinc supplements are once again synthetic, isolated. You're not sure if you're actually able to absorb and use that. And once again, if it's so isolated, so high dose, that can throw off your copper balance. So it might not be an issue. If you want to experiment, of course, go ahead. For example, if you're coming from a place of copper overload, maybe it's okay. Maybe you can just have some zinc and feel good benefits from that. But overall, of course, I will always suggest real foods, the most effective way to get all of these nutrients. And I already mentioned the dried oysters. I also made a post about this supplement, so check it out. All the links are down in the description below. But the main idea for these videos is to give you this concentrated information. Like, I do a lot of research for these videos, for these posts. So you're getting something that is combined from all sorts of different viewpoints, experiences, articles, research papers, and so on, studies as well. So that is enough for you, I think, to know about zinc. Thank you for watching. Stay strong, stay consistent. The next video to watch will appear on the screen now, and I'm going to walk the dog. I have a daily walk, 3 kilometers, and that will also deserve its own video. I might do that for next week. So see you then.